Hi students, once again welcome back to the world of English. In today's session we are going to deal with the collocations. Okay, we'll be dealing with or we'll be coming to know the definition of collocations, and we are also going to deal with the six type of collocations. Okay, now what is meant by collocation? A collocation is an arrangement of words or other elements, especially those commonly co-occur. Okay, in simple terms, group of words that usually go together, okay, that correspond to some conventional way of saying things. Okay, do you understand? Now English has a number of common collocations. That's what we are going to deal. We are going to see six types of collocations. Okay, in simple term, collocation is an arrangement of words or other elements. Okay, it is act of occurring side by side. Do you understand? When we start doing the examples, you will understand. Okay, so the first type of collocation we are going to see is adjective plus noun, because already we have learned that collocation is arrangement of words, okay, occurring side by side. Now in first form we have adjective plus noun. You know it already, right? What is an adjective and noun? Okay, adjective is a describing word and noun is a naming word, right? So in the first type we see collocation, adjective plus noun. Okay, let's see some examples. He has been a heavy smoker and drinker all his adult life. Now when you observe the sentence, heavy is actually an adjective. Okay, smoker is noun. Do you understand? The act of occurring side by side, heavy smoker, adjective plus noun. Is it clear? The next one we have, she speaks English quite well but with a strong French accent. Okay, she speaks English quite well but with a strong French accent. Okay, now strong is adjective, okay, accent is noun. Do you understand what is meant by accent? It's the modulation of voice in speaking or articulation of syllables or utterance of words. Okay, so here what does it mean? She speaks English quite well but he has that the accent of French. Okay, strong accent of French. Strong is actually adjective, right? Accent is noun. Is it clear? Let's see the next one. They have a hard life and worked through a hard time. They have a hard life and worked through a hard time. Now see, hard is an adjective. Okay, life is noun. Hard life, act of occurring side by side. Okay, hard life, adjective plus noun. Hard time, again it's collocation. Do you understand? Hard is adjective, time is noun. I believe it's clear, right? So the first type we have learnt is adjective plus noun. Okay, collocations that are formed with the help of adjective plus noun. Is it clear? The next type we have, noun plus noun. Noun is naming word, right? Now here it refers to collective noun. Now what is meant by collective noun? It is a name given to group of people or things. Okay, for example, we call group of birds as flock of birds. Okay, a bunch of keys, bunch of banana. Okay, do you understand? So the second type of collocations are formed with the help of noun plus noun. Okay, now let's see some examples. Would you like to have a cup of tea? Cup of tea. Okay, cup is a noun and coffee is again noun. Is it clear? The second one we have, he will give you a bar of chocolate, to his girlfriend on Valentine's Day. He will give a bar of chocolate to his girlfriend on Valentine's Day. Do you understand? It's clear, right? Next. Her bucket of flour is the best of all. Her bucket of flour is the best of all. It's a collective noun. Bucket of flowers. Bucket of flowers. Clear? The third type of collocations that we are going to see is a combination of verb and noun. You know it already, right? What is verb? Verb is an action word. Okay. So, the third type of collocations are formed with the help of verb plus noun. Let's see some examples. I always try to do my homework in the morning after making my bed. Okay. I always try to do my homework in the morning after making my bed. Okay. Do you understand? Do homework. Okay. Do homework. Making bed. Do homework. Do is verb. Homework is noun. Is it clear? The next one. Do you think the bank would forgive a debt? Do you think the bank would forgive a debt? Now forgive is verb. Debt is noun. Okay. So the collocation is the, you know, arrangement of words side by side. And the third form of collocations we are, learning is verb plus noun. Verb plus noun. So forgive plus debt. Is it clear? The next one, we are going to have lunch together. Would you like to join? Have lunch. Have is verb and lunch is noun. Clear? Simple. The third form is formed with the help of verb plus noun. Okay? Verb plus noun. Do homework. Forgive debt. Have lunch. Is it clear? The fourth type of collocations are formed with the help of adverb and adjective. Okay, the collocations are formed with the help of adverb and adjective. Okay, now let's see some of the examples. This test is ridiculously easy. Ridiculously easy. Ridiculously is adverb. Okay, adverb of manner. Easy is adjective. Okay, so this test is ridiculously easy. Adverb plus adjective. I didn't even study, but I will get high score. Okay. The next one. Janet is a highly successful businesswoman. She owns several restaurants and hotels around the country. Highly successful. Highly is again adverb. Okay. Highly is again adverb. Successful is adjective. Highly successful. Clear? And the last one we have, that is utterly ridiculous. Utterly is adverb. Utterly is adverb. Ridiculous is adjective. Okay. So here in this fourth form, we have the collocations. You know, the collocations are formed with the help of adverb plus adjective. Utterly ridiculous. Okay. So that is utterly ridiculous. She didn't steal your favorite book. She wasn't even in the office yesterday. Clear? So the fifth form of collocations are formed with the help of verb plus adverb. Okay, you know it already, right? What is verb? Verb and adverb. Okay, so the fifth form of collocations are formed with the help of verb and adverb. Okay, now the accident happened because he was driving dangerously. Driving dangerously. Verb plus adverb. How did he drive? Dangerously. Okay. The next one. After 2 years in London, he speaks English fluently. Okay. The next one we have. I waited patiently, but he never came. I waited patiently, but he never came. Waited is verb. Patiently is adverb. Okay. So, dear students, I believe we have understood today's session, right? So, in simple terms, collocation, you know, refers to the act of occurring side by side, okay? Word partnership or words that are commonly used together, okay? They are used together, word plus word collocations, okay? And we have seen different types of collocations, how they are formed, adjective plus adverb. Okay, noun plus noun, verb plus adverb, right? So I believe you have understood it today's session. See you in the next session. Till then, take care. Bye.